19th of December. Can anybody recognize what is this? Anyone, please.
Like I put a fresh sheet like this. I put a fresh stick out it here to this. Put it into this stack. That I want to impress upon you. There's a stack. Every household use it, whether you knowingly or unknowingly. Maybe your grandparents, may not be your parents, the grandparents must be using this kind of stack other than power file. Cover file also, they put up the latest first, that is also stack architecture, and there are some households, they use it. In my household, my parents use it, it's very useful. You get it all the latest paid electricity bill. Nowadays, you pay by Google Pay or any other way, you have a lot of way to remember it, but earlier days, the hand printed bill comes, if it is missed, then you can get a disconnection charge. So, we have to, even this might lost it. So, we have to keep the at least 1 year electricity bills, EC bills in a this kind of stack. My father used to maintain it. So, this is very useful. Stack is very useful whenever you at your household, you will see if you put your crockeries, if your mother or grandmother put the crockeries in a stack. If old newspaper, if you want to search it quickly, the last 3 days, generally you don't search the last 3 months, you want the last 3 days, then you put all everything on the stack, last in, first out. So, stack is very useful. Another usefulness of stack is probably you come to know only by coming to this formal language in automata theory, that is push down automata. That is the fantastic use of stack, that is whenever you a to the power n, b to the power n recognition, then how do you know how to recognize this push down automata? You imaginarily you think of a stack and you put A into it and then whenever B coming you pop A and it matches, you throw away. You take another B, pop, and throw away. So, this is A to the power n, U to the power n, the pushdown automata or parenthesis grammar, which is the foundation of our procedural programming, our context free grammar. Everything can be visualized with a single stack. You might wonder why, if we have a two stack, then I can maintain A to the power n, B to the power n, C to the power n. I put B A's into one stack, B into another stack, two stack, and whenever C comes, I pop A from one and B from other stack. That is, I can have with two stack, we can give an A to the power n, B to the power n, C to the power n language. That is a context sensitive language, but that's not true. How to synchronize these two stack? So, everywhere you see, the only with single stack, you have to manage the whole show. So, you cannot, you have multiple stack, that is a luxury, but you cannot. So, you know very well, the context sensitive grammar cannot be done by Pulsion automata. You need a bounded Turing machine, so that a Turing machine go one step forward or one step backward or read and write. That can only solve this A to the power n, B to the power n, C to the power n language. Anyway, stack is, coming back to stack again, then you come to know depth first search tree. Depth first search, whenever you visit root node, then it has child, so put child into the stack, then go to the leftmost child, the eldest child, go to visit his residence, something like that, and there are so many childs, so you push all to the stack, then again eldest child you visit, then you come back. It is also useful of the stack. So, with stack you can traverse depth first search. That is another great example of stack. Another is you fit whenever you go for like any word or any PowerPoint presentation, if you see, you can do undo maybe 10 steps or 100 steps. So, every activity whatever doing, they put it into a stack. So, every program or every task, let us say every program can its own stack. Like in your CPU might have only one stack, but whenever you come to know the global memory map, so every program had its own stack and heap. So, they put their value into their stack. A word might have right now 10 documents. For 10 documents, they might have 10 small task threads, and every thread has its own stack. So, that is it. So, stack is very useful. Here also we see last day's class, I think we should be clear that the stack is used. It is a basically a top down LL1 parsing table. What is there in the stack? We push first the S or the starting symbol. First, everywhere this is input. This input can go only from left to right. No, no, like no left and right, like Turing machine sort of movement is not allowed, then the complexity would be more. So input can go only one step at a time. Whenever it reaches at the end of the thing, that is dollar comes, and when the stack is empty with the dollar, then we say nothing is there and nothing is there. In top down parsing, we say it is really great. So it is accepted.
So this is top down LL parsing. What does it do?
The whole input, I put it here, and I first put S, starting symbol, and then S, we start the leftmost symbol, we try to go to the our table, our parsing table, that we have made it from first of A, first of B and all, and we try to match the production rules, we try to match the production rules and put it, the production rule, the derivation in reverse, so that again we try to match this. There might be a condition that here is a terminal and here is a terminal that doesn't match, the parsing stops and that is an error. If the terminal must match, if it is doesn't match, then there's error. And another situation, there is a terminal and same terminal is there, then it can go ahead this, and this terminal is thrown off, pop out and take it out. So then the any other variable comes, then if it's a variable comes, what condition can be? It can be here everyone is terminal, here it can be variable or terminal. Terminal matches, fine. This cursor will go right side and this will pop up. Then if the variable terminal, then I have to find it out the variable terminal, go to the parsing table, is there any rule is there? If there is no rule, fine, then parsing error. If there is a rule, derivation, that the derivation, whole derivation push onto it, okay. And here you know the rule, the left hand side will be the top of the stack. Again you check whether the top of the stack, whether it matches or not. This is very simple for the LL1 parsing table. You know how to create parsing table. That's great. I have last class I have done it. If you don't understand, I can go again. And there is a beautiful thing is bottom up parser. Bottom up parser is the same thing. Here the parsing program different. Here also they use the same stack. Okay. Input is also same. It goes from this side to this side. And there is also parsing table. But this parsing table is different. The parsing table here, whatever in top down parsing, we put S into the first and a whole sentence is there. And in the bottom of parsing, that is the last step. The last step, there would be the S, and first derivation of S to this, there will be, it will be there. The first step will be all terminals will be there. Then we take one at a terminal and push into a stack. Okay, push into a stack. And then this stack, we try to match. Is there any rule so that the right hand side is the top of the stack? Are you getting me? So in bottom up parsing, we try to parse it from the bottom up. So we push to the stack and try to match. Is there any rule to this? Then if this is rule, then again, if you do not rule, then push another. You take down this one, then this one push. So some way it comes to maybe here, and then you feel it here, certain derivation can be made. So we take those terminals and put it to the variables rules here. Then that way this can be reduced. So it is called shift, and here it will be reduced by the rule. The rule number, and this is shift and the reduce. This is the called shift reduce parser. At the end of it, there would be S here starting, and there will be starting with S the production rules, one or two production, maybe one, at least might be one production rule. The corresponding value should be here. So then we take out, it is matches, otherwise it doesn't matter. This is simply a bottom up parsing, but here the parsing table is cannot be done so easily. Like in the top down parsing, we have just very simple, we calculate fast, mainly fast, follow we require for something, mainly fast, but follow you have to do. And if it is a nullable, we have to say first of that variable, and intersection of follow up that variable should be shy. And we create the parsing table, and when the parsing table is made, and if there is one and only one entry per cell, then and there is entries, some of the boxes can be vacant, that doesn't matter, but entry should be one and only. Then you can 100% say it is a deterministic context free grammar, this is the unambiguous grammar. See, most lot of things can be said. So any context free grammar, whether it is unambiguous and ambiguous, there is no sure shot of testing it. Yes, but if you create LL1 parsing table, then you can say 100% this grammar is unambiguous. Ambiguous grammar cannot be. And you can also say the grammar is that doesn't have left recursion. So if there is a left recursion, you cannot make a parsing table, top down parsing table. Left recursion can be avoided by left factoring. Even left recursion, removal of left recursion with by left factoring, the grammar is not LL1. Okay, so the very please kindly remember there are some questions like me like this to test your knowledge. The grammar is only LL1 whenever you create the rules I have said that way, or you can create a parsing table, and the parsing table should be one and only entry or no entry. Okay, so if it is that grammar is deterministic, context free, unambiguous, and LL1 grammar, and it can be parsed in over in time, but this is a but the very subset of context free grammar is LL1 grammar. Better subset would be LR1 grammar, that I have discussed right now. I may be discussing one or two lectures later, so also next lectures also. So, but I wish to thank you that you please think in terms of stack and you try to make this. I will give one or two small 2-3 minutes assignment to you, so that I will take the assignment in the class itself if it's possible. So you try to visualize these animations. So that what is going on the parsing table, say top down parsing, it will be first S, I should fill it, and whole input string is there. In bottom up parsing, whole input string will be there, and on both the cases it will go from left to right. And the bottom up parsing, you take the input from here and pushed into it, keeping on pushing and keeping on checking whether I can get any reduction rule, where you have the rules, and the reduction rules you try to find. If you cannot, maybe you come at the end, maybe at all the reduction can be at the end, no issue. Maybe all the reduction go to after this, then the automatic thing will come, then you will see the, you see some, it catch a reduction rule, then put the reduction rule here, then another reduction, reduce, all the subsequent reduced in the S will come. Then when this one is vacant and S is here, then you can say your parse down is complete. And beauty of it, the LR parsing, you left recursion allowed, so you don't have to modify your grammar by left factoring. So it is a broader range of grammar. But here also there are some conflict would be, sometimes the conflict would be whether to reduce or whether to shift. In some situation, you might have two options. You can reduce it or you can shift it. You have both the two rules are available. Then the conflict is there. How to avoid the conflict? Though everything is written in your parsing table. The parsing table is right now not that simple LL1 parsing table. It is, and you are pushing into the stack not only the symbols, you are pushing it some states. So your stack is now not only contains the like top down parsing stack is only takes the variables and terminals, and here not here is variables, terminals and state. The state portion is added, and the state is, you have to calculate the state, which state this is. So here you have some action. The action can be whether to shift, that whether input should be shift to right side, whether to reduce means reduce the stack by the rules. Shifting you just to ignore the reduce, then whether you accept the last stage and error. Okay, so these are the four actions, and there's a go to table. One is deterministic finite automata. There are table, there's the action table can be very huge for LR1. LR1 is the superset. It takes most of the grammar. LR1, if you look ahead, only one symbol. LR2, look ahead, only two symbols. Mostly they are taken LR1, and the table, the LLR and SLR, basic things are same, only number of entries are less. Table is much simpler. You are combining these DFS states into this. So we'll try it. We'll try to understand LR0 and LR1, or better LR1, LR0 and LR1. If we understand this, then SLR and LLR, it is the combining the states, the parsing driver, the combining the DFA. Here the DFA, here is a parsing table, number of states will be less. So table will be smaller, and your online, because you know there are in a programming language there may be 200 or 400 rules, and the tables can go to the megabyte level or more. So reduction of table should be there. So that is the reason most of the language, maybe LLR or SLR, the tables are compressed. We'll go to it, but I'll try to visualize this thing, that difference between top down parsing and bottom up parsing. Top down parsing, you put only the S here into the stack. Top down parsing, pull S and you matches terminal to first of terminal, first of S and this one. And in the production rules, you put it into the upside down. So the left one should be here, and this way you try to match as it goes. By the top down and by bottom up parsing, S comes here at the last stage, and whenever S comes, then here everything should be your one production rule. So you can reduce S, okay? All the things will become here. You reduce to S here. Then means you have accepted this one. This is just recapitulation of top-down parsing. Top-down parsing one is with backtrack. Remember, with backtrack, you can parse top-down parsing. Everything is possible, but only backtrack means time computation is more, your complexity is more. But backtrack also unambiguous grammar and ambiguous grammar it can do. So the backtrack is not a untouchable. So sometimes backtrack is required. You know the recursive descent. Next better parsing in top down is recursive. Backtrack is allowed, but whenever backtrack is absolutely not allowed, and also recursive descent, that is LL1 parsing. LL1 parsing means there will be no backtrack and there will be no recursion is there. No backtrack, and so without backtrack parsing is recursive descent is a LL1 parsing. LL1 parsing table, one good point is whenever you very easy to even by hand calculation, you create the first calculation, you create the follow table. If any variable is nullable, you take the first of that variable, intersection follow of that variable should be shy. And if a variable goes to alpha 1, backwards not from alpha 2, alpha 3, then first of alpha 1, first of alpha 2, first of alpha 3 should, intersection should be shy. So, if a production rule terminal with a variable, that terminal should not be available in any other production rule of that variable. Have you understood? So, if I get a variable, if I see A is equal to AB, there will be no other rule, but here it is there. So, this is not LL1 parsing. By looking at this, you can say this is not LL1 because the two production rules have the same terminal at the beginning. So this is not, so you need a, here you need a backtrack, doesn't match, then it matches this time. So this is not LL1. LL1 parsing with deterministic finite state machine, like deterministic finite state machine, every step is guaranteed, whether you accept or not, same as LL1 parsing, is everything is guaranteed, and you will get O(n) time the your parsing output, whether accepted or rejected. So, but for becoming LL1 parsing, you already know this, the grammar has to be deterministic, context-free grammar, no left recursion, but that is not, doesn't guarantee. Even a grammar can be found, deterministic, context-free grammar without left recursion, direct or indirect, but cannot be LL1. We whether your grammar is LL1 or not, you have to create that table. You have to create the all variables to be nullable or not. You have to make a separate column nullable or not, and then you go first of that variable, first set of that variable, which are the terminals can come first and follow, which are the terminal can after the variable. With this table, you can create the parsing table. All the variables should be left hand side and terminal should be right hand side, and every entry should have only one and only rule. So, and there might be no rule. So, if this table can be, this parsing table can be make such a way that there is no duplicate entries, the grammar is guaranteed LL1 parsing table, and they are using this. So, let's see what else today. LRK is that is our next focus. LRK that will be we'll go for LR0, okay, and then go for LR1. If we understand all, then all others are like child's play. So, LR1 we try to the problem with resolution with shift shift reduce. Shift shift means for the input is I will shift ignore, or I in the stack I put the terminals and variables there, whether I can reduce it or not. Reduce, ultimately all reduction on the stack, it will come to S. So that is the success of LR parser. Okay. With this, I am ending today's 19th December class. I try to make a note and also try to make a better video offline. So thank you very much.